cuties. I'm back on this thirsty Thursday. Feeling a little parched, are you? Well, we've got your dose of Trivia Tonic to help you with that. And did you know it's National Submarine Day? Maybe that's why I'm here submerged underwater right now. I'm in a bubble. Luckily, there's a little air in here, but it could run out at any moment. That wouldn't be good, would it? Who would bring you your afternoon trivia if I croak? Don't worry, I'm about to burst this bubble and perhaps yours too. After 12 rounds, here we go. That's better. Now I'm feeling in full effect. I'm Sharon Carpenter, your British Cardi B. I can rhyme too. This is HQ with fun games and cash just for you. Okay? Impressed, right? We're in deep to season 3 right now, and you know how the game's played. I'm gonna ask you a series of questions from easy to hard. You've got 10 seconds to tap that answer. Get it correct, you move on. Answer all 12 right, you win, or you split that cash. And today we're giving away a plentiful $2,500. That's enough for you to go scuba diving if submarines aren't your thing, or just have a bunch of fun on land. Why not? Now tonight, we are traveling to the land of gamers. Pull out your consoles, it's video game night. Whether you're down with Pac-Man, Mario Kart, or Fortnite, we've got tons of fun in store for you, all starting at 9 p.m. Eastern this evening. Can't wait for that. And then Sunday, winter is back again in a great way. Game of Thrones trivia will be going down at a special time, 8:30 p.m. Eastern. The night is dark and full of terrors. Will you make it out alive and share a slice of that $10,000 pie? I hope so, for your sake. Extra lives keep the fun going. They can keep you in the game even when you get a question wrong. You can buy one right now if you see it on your screen. Use an extra life on any round at all, aside from the final one, because it's not going to work. Now, we're going to play a little game I like to call Shazza's Celebrity Corner. I'm Shazza. I'm going to tell you some personalized celeb stories. You have to guess which star I'm talking about, okay? Let's see who guesses right first. You'll get a shout out from me. Okay, this was the only person who ever got me starstruck during a sit-down interview with him. I was so overwhelmed by his dashing good looks, I could hardly speak. My mouth was moving, but the words weren't coming out. He just sat there smiling kindly with his chin-length brunette hair. No, it's not Tom Cruise and Alita, but that was a nice guess. Longer hair than Tom Cruise, used to have those boyish good looks. Ooh, he was handsome. Too hot for TV, which is why he's a movie star. Not Anderson Cooper. You were very close though. B-Mar A580. That was a good one, but not Anderson Cooper. Definitely not. Guess again. All right, I'm gonna have to give you a big clue. He had scissors for hands in a movie. Yeah, that guy. Okay, we have a winner. Smart 855, you are smart. It was Johnny Depp. Look at him. Gorgeous, isn't he? Here's another. Okay, she's Trini American, but she says my name with a better British accent than I do. Loves imitating the English accent, has great performance skills. She's not a fan of the rapper I mentioned earlier. Trini American. Super talented. Who could she be? It's not Rihanna, Ryan C. Greenwood. But that was a good guess. She's Bayesian, not Trini American. She's a rapper. She's not a fan of Cardi B necessarily. Come on, you Barbies. That not Kate Blanchett, really. Sonic 70. Nah, thumbs down for that one. Kate. Come on, guys. Okay, we've got a winner. Slawhouse, Slawhorse. Well done to you, it's Nicki Minaj, and here she is.
I'm Sharon Carpenter, and this is Nicki Minaj.
See, great accent, right? Here's the last one, time for one more. He calls me Shazza every time I run into him on red carpets. Tall, dark, and handsome, and I don't know one woman who would throw him out of bed. Some of you guys wouldn't either. Shazza is a British nickname for Sharon, so he's probably British. We bonded on the red carpet. Who could it possibly be? Anyone out there with the correct answer? I'm gonna give it to you. It's Idris Elba! That's who. Let's count it down. And we do have a winner. Cigar Ryan is smoking his cigar. He got Idris Elba. Well done to you. Three winners. Good stuff. Okay, superstars, you know what time it is. Time to get to the quizzing. We want to see more winners today. Here we go with Q1. What's the primary ingredient in butter? Margarine, mayonnaise, milk. See your minds churning there. What could it be? If you went for mayonnaise, you've got egg on your face already. You make butter with milk, of course. You did not spill the milk, 108,000 of you didn't. Butter is usually made using cow's milk, but can be created from other mammals too, like sheep, goats, and humans, if you like. I didn't say try it, kind of gross, right? Now, you all want to level up as high as you can this season, so we are here to help. You can buy points multipliers if you see it on your screen right now, do you? Well, the more points you earn, the higher the level, the better chance you have of winning the season 3 grand prize, and it's gonna be humongous. Q2, which movie innovation typically requires special glasses for viewing? IMAX, 3D, Dolby Surround. Fun and games until your eyes start throbbing halfway through. If you went for Dolby Surround, you weren't listening, were you? Seeing things in a better dimension, a third dimension, is 3D, 119,000 if you're moving on to the next dimension of this game. Now, you don't need glasses to watch a movie on IMAX, it's just a really big screen, but for that 3D effect, you have to rock some cheap shades, the green and the red ones. You've done it before. Q3. This is the first known image of what? Take a gander at that. What could that be? Could that be a black hole, atomic nucleus, or Bigfoot? It's an image that just came out recently. It looks like my left eye in the morning, but not quite as red. This is the first known image of a black hole. That's what it is, people. 115,000 of you out of the hole there. Now, if you thought Bigfoot was hard to capture, so was this black hole. It took many years and a world-spanning network of telescopes for that pick to reach us today. Q4. The sponsors of Columbus's first voyage were from what modern-day country? Spain, Portugal, Italy. We're talking Christopher here. Christopher Columbus. Columbus made 4 voyages across the Atlantic and acted like he owned everything he came across. He was Italian, but the cash was from Spain. España, 96,000 of you knew that. You're all about that cash. Now, his sponsors, Ferdinand and Isabella, were from Aragon and Castile. I wonder if they'll sponsor me on a Caribbean cruise this summer. No harm in asking, right? Q5. Which of these famous people does not have one of the 20 most followed Twitter accounts? Jimmy Fallon, Bill Gates, Harry Styles. Whose Twitter fingers make it onto that list? Now, this will have you going in one direction, probably the wrong direction. Can you believe that Hazza did not make the list of top tweeters as Harry Styles? That was a savage. I knew it would be. 80,000 of you are down here on Q5. 32,000 of you are moving in the right direction today. Now, the late night host and the super rich geek have the 19th and 20th biggest accounts, while Harry is all the way down at 42. What is going on there? Q6. A TV movie about New York Yankees great Roger Maris was titled 61, followed by what symbol? Ellipsis? Asterisk? Interrobang? What's that symbol we're looking for? If you went for interrobang, you just went out with a bang, unfortunately. Never heard of that before, but I do know this. Asterisk. You took the risk and it paid off. 83,000 if you did. Now, Maris went after Babe Ruth's home run record in 61, but it was embroiled in controversy, so the record book slapped his name with a caveat, and so did the movie. Q7. Which scientific word has ironic origins given what we now know about it? Atom, gravity, or star? Ooh, the irony of it all. Gravity is from the Latin for weight. There may be iron there, but no irony. It's atom, man. You're up an atom. 35,000 of you are, and that was kind of savage too. That was kind of savage too. 60,000 of you are gone. 35,000 of you are moving on. The word atom is from the Greek for indivisible. And since we've been splitting atoms for some time now, I'm sure you can see the irony in it, can't you? Q8. What has been the busiest day for KFC restaurants in the US in recent years? Veterans Day, day before Thanksgiving, or Mother's Day? Which day could it be? It's finger looking good, you know. All right, which of you are the cheapskates? So your mom cooks you healthy meals all year round and you repay her with a trip to KFC on Mother's Day. That's the day in question. Oh, we gonna triple the savage. Let's do it. Almost 30,000 of you gone. 14,000 if you got Mother's Day. You love your mama, don't ya? Now to make matters worse, KFC released a romance novel a couple of Mother's Days ago titled Tender Wings of Desire. And it was actually good. Q9, which card game does not use standard 52-card decks? Cribbage, Pinnacle, or Baccarat? I completely messed up the pronunciation of that one. Okay, there are 52 weeks in a year, but there aren't 52 cards in this game, a few cards short of a full deck. It's Pinnacle, however you pronounce that, and 7,167 of you playing your cards right there. That was a toughie. Now, it has 48 cards. It has duplicates of 9 through ace in all 4 suits, but I still haven't figured out what the missing 4 cards are. If you know, let me know in the chat. Q10, which of these countries is entirely landlocked? Bosnia and Herzegovina, Iraq, Ethiopia. A few tongue twisters in this game today. It's for the landlubbers out there. New York doesn't have the best beaches, but they're better than nothing. Dry as my mouth when I interview Johnny Depp. Ethiopia. That's the country in question. 3,092 of you got that unlock. Ethiopia is the most populous landlocked nation on Earth. It's so close to water, but a couple of nations happen to be in the way. Get out the way. It's Q11, the penultimate round. The James Blunt song Tears and Rain references a novel by what writer? Henry Miller, Oscar Wilde, Victor Hugo. Tears and Rain, if you get this wrong, because you are so close. Track 5 on Back to Bedlam gets pretty depressing, to be blunt. Wilder now, it references a novel by Oscar Wilde. You know your novels, 2,589 of you do. On the track, Blunt sings, "Hides my true shape, like Dorian Gray." No, he's not talking about a spare pair of Spanx. It's Wilde's gothic horror novel. All right, read up, players, because we are heading into the final chapter with 2,589 players left in the game, another 500 using extra lives to get back in. $2,500 in the bag today. Good luck, players. Oprah once famously tweeted from an iPad instead of what device she was supposed to be promoting. Pixelbook, Surface, Galaxy Tab. This was absolutely hilarious. It was the funniest tweet ever. She must have been paid a hefty fee by the company to promote this device, but use the competition to tweet about it instead. Can't get anything past some of you eagle-eyed internet users. Bill Gates was probably miffed. It's the Microsoft Surface for the win. We've got 1,581 winners. You smash this! Congratulations to our 1,581 winners. You survived a triple savage in the game today. You're taking on $1.58. We've got Barrow Cad right there. We've got Tommy. Tommy with a big smile and mustache. We've got Call Me Janie. Okay, Janie, well done to you. DP262 with a big smiley emoji face, and you should be smiling as well because you're a winner. One of 1,581 winners today. I'm really impressed. Well done, HQTs. That was awesome as always. You came, you played, you totally slayed. I'm Sharon Carpenter. Here's where you can find me on the socials. Yeah, stop by, say hi. Don't be shy. And we'll be back tonight with a fun theme in store for you. Video game nights, all night, starting at 9 p.m. Eastern with trivia followed by words at 9:30 p.m. Eastern. Can't wait for that. I will see you gamers tonight. Bye.